Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Third year, how you all put up? I hope, inshallah, with the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everybody will be fine and enjoying safe and sound health, and everybody will be taking precautionary measures in order to save her or him from that particular disease. Okay, beta. So as you know that we started yesterday our second poem, that is Tajri, and dear students, this poem has been written by Walter de la Mare, and you know that this poem, as I told you yesterday, that this poem Tajri is an imaginative poem. Dear students, it is a journey into the realm of imagination. Okay, the poet wants to become the ruler of an imaginary land. An imaginary land where he found a lot of things, and his court would be made of gold, and his throne would be made of gold, and his dress would be made of beads, and he would be the sole owner of rivers, lakes, and a lot of things had been discussed by the author. And these all things show the inner desire of the author, of the writer. Okay, beta? So I explained the first two stanzas yesterday, and now I will explain the next stanzas. Okay, beta? Okay, beta. As you can see that on the screen there are stanza number 3. Okay, let's read it. If I were Lord of Tajri, I would wear a robe of beads, white and gold and green they would be, and cluster thick as seeds, and earth should when the morning star, I would don my robe and scimitar, and zebra salmon to draw my car, though Tajri is dark glades. Give it us, this is the stanza, and first of all I will tell the meaning of the difficult words. Okay, so have a look on the difficult words. So if I were Lord of Tajri, Lord means king, so the poet is saying in this line that if he would be the king of Tajri, that is an imaginative land, I would wear a robe of beads. Okay beta, what is robe? Robe means dress. And what is wear mean put on, pehenna. Okay, so beads, what are beads? Beads are small perforated balls, means say jisko hum kehte hain moti. Okay, manke jisko hum urdu mein kehte hain. And white and gold and green they would be, and cluster means crowded. Okay, crowded thick as seeds mean jo ke beej hote hain. Okay, so what is the poet is saying in these first four lines? The poet is saying that if he were the lord of the imaginary land Tajri, he would wear a gorgeous dress. Okay, it would be decorated with beads and white, golden and green colors. Okay, so if I were lord of Tajri, I would wear a robe of beads, mean to say his dress. Okay, but look at his imagination, that his dress, it would be made of beads and pearls, and a lot of things would be mentioned, would be, and it would be woven with a lot of things. Most of the things would be made of beads, and their colors would be white and gold and green they would be. Okay, or the beads, beta, they would be of different colors, and all these colors, they would be entangled in such a way that, and clustered thick as seeds, and cluster mean they would be like this cluster and crowded root, they mean to say there were a lot of beards put together in order to make his royal dress. So this is the imagination of the poet, that he would wear a very elegant dress, and it would show him that he was a sole owner of his imaginative land, that is Tajri. Okay, okay, next is an earl mean before. Okay, an earl should when the morning star. Okay, when mean fade. Okay, should fade the morning star, we mean to say before fading before winning the morning star, before disappearing the morning star. Because he is saying that he would get up very early in the morning, beta. Okay, before wedding, before feeding the morning star. Do you know, students, that when before it gets dawn, we and there is a little bit evening, or you can say a darkness. Okay, so we found a star over there. It is called morning star. It is alone, one and only star is found on the sky, and it is called morning star. जिसका उर्दू में सुबह का सितारा कहते हैं. Okay. So he said that before waiting that morning star, I would get up. मैं जल्दी में उठ जाता. And I would turn my robe and sweater. Okay, बेटा वो क्या करता? And I should before the morning star, done put on clothes. And I done my robe, means robe mean dress. And I put on my dress. Okay. And sweater a short carved sword. Okay, sweater a short carved sword, जैसे एक dagger कहते हैं. ठीक है, तो जैसे छोटा सा खंजर होता है उस टाइप का कहते हैं. ओके. एंड ज़ेब्रा सेवन शुड ड्रॉ माय कार. ओके बेटा, ड्रॉ माय कार मीन सेवन ज़ेब्रास वुड ड्राइव हिज कार. ओके, सेवन ज़ेब्रास बेटा. एंड ग्लेड ब्लू आई चार्ट इज डार्क ग्लेड अ सनी पाथ थ्रू अ थिक फॉरेस्ट. सो वेयर वुड ही गो वाइल ड्रैगिंग ऑफ दोज सेवन ज़ेब्रास बेटा. That he's look at his imagination that, and all these things but show that human imagination has no boundaries at all. As I told yesterday that it is your mind, it is your thinking that wherever you go through your imagination. So beta, is point me to it has ended the imagination. Okay, beta, it is a very beautiful and musical poem. And I personally I like it very much. Because it gives me a relief that when I study, when I read this poem, it takes me to another world. So where I may get relief from my personal, or you can say the problems and that we face daily. ठीक है बेटा. एंड सो वेन यू विल फील दिस वे बेटा, ट्राई टू फील द पोएट्री. दिस इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ द पोएट्री दैट यू हैव यू इफ यू आर रियली अ गुड रीडर. And just try to read the poem through your heart, beta. फिर दिल से उस चीज को पढ़े. And just feel it. And just imagine the things, the world that the writer is trying to create in front of you. Then you will enjoy the poetry that is a spontaneous flow, overflow, powerful feeling. But this is the you can say definition of the poetry that it is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feeling. कि आपके दिल से जो powerful feeling निकलती उसका एक spontaneous एक अचानक जो आपके दिल से चीज निकलती बेटा, this is expression of your inner feeling. So the poet they are all ordinary person ना, तो वही feel करते हैं बेटा जो कि इधर उधर वो देखते हैं, अपने मुआशरे में देखते हैं. So Walter Reed में he is also, I think his this effort is this one is a you can say escape from the world of reality into the world of imagination. ठीक है बेटा, because in the world of reality we find a lot of difficulties, a lot of problems in our life, but the world of imagination it is so much beautiful. And but we have to come back to our world of reality because this is the life. Okay, so he's saying that seven zebras, seven horses or zebras, they would draw my car and I would walk through the way, and his carriage would be driven by seven zebras through the shining sunny paths of the forest of the touch. But a last stanza, Lord of the fruits of Chatri, her river silver pale, Lord of the hills of Chatri, glen, thicket, wood and dale. Her flashing stars, her scented breeze, her trembling lakes, like formless seas, her bird and lightning, citron trees in every purple veil. What a line, beta. So what is the poet saying that? Lord of the, even he wanted to be the lord of the fruits and trees and the rivers of the Chatri, beta. And the river, they were of silver, pale color. You say, look at the beauty of the river, that they were having silver. Of course, the river, the color of the water is like silver, or you can say pure जैसे ट्रांसपेरेंट होता है, ठीक है. सो सेइंग दैट इट वुड बी ऑफ सिल्वर पेल कलर, ठीक है. द रिवर्स दे वुड हैव अ वेरी स्प्लेंडेड कलर, सो ही वुड बी द ऑनर, ऑल दीज थिंग्स वुड बी इन हिज कंट्रोल, ठीक है बेटा. लॉर्ड ऑफ द हिल्स ऑफ छत्री एंड ही वुड बी ऑल्सो द लॉर्ड ऑफ द हिल्स ऑफ टाटी, मीन से कि ही वॉन्ट्स टू इंजॉय द प्लेजर एंड कम्फर्ट ऑफ ऑल टाइप्स. He would become the lord of fruits of all kinds available in Chautri. He would have an access to all kinds of fruits. The land of Chautri would be very beautiful and exotic with a lord of the hills, and he would be the lord of the hills of the Chautri as well. Okay? So what kind of glen? Glen means with a valley. Okay? And thicket? Thicket means thickly green bush. And woods, of course, forest and dale. Dale means valley. Dale ko bhi valley kehte hain. Okay. So he said that he would be the lord of the hills of Chautri. The land of the Chautri would contain green valleys, thickets and green forest. Okay? Glen, thicket, would these all things were would be found in the Chautri, and he would, the land would exercise the most delightful influence on the boy, because he, this is his imagination that he would be the owner of such type of land where all these beautiful and ending these things that would have ending beauty, okay? Endless beauty of the these things, he would be the owner, he would be the ruler of all these things. This is his desire. Her flashing stars, okay, her mean it is used for land, but aapko pata hai ki for sea, for countries we use her, ठीक है. इसका फिनोनम जो है, सॉरी इसका जो प्रोनाउंस है वो जो है वो फेमिनिन यूज होता है. ओके, हर फ्लैशिंग स्टार्स, हर सेंटिक ब्रीज. ओके बेटा, फ्लैशिंग स्टार्स, फ्लैशिंग स्टार की मीन टू से के शाइनिंग. सो फ्लैशिंग मीन शाइनिंग, उसके स्टार जो दे आर शाइनिंग. और सेंटिक ब्रीज, सेंटिक मीन फ्रेग्रेंट, ब्यूटिफुल, हैव अ क्वाइट यू कैन से सूदिंग सेंट, ठीक है. ब्रीज, ब्रीज मीन एयर. एंड हर ट्रेवलिंग लेक्स, द लेक ट्रेवलिंग लेक्स, एक्चुअली द लेक्स आर नॉट ट्रेवलिंग, द वॉटर इन द लेक्स इट इज ट्रेवलिंग बेटा. सो ही सेइंग दैट इट्स ट्रेवलिंग लेक, लेक फॉर्मलेस सीज. एंड फॉर्मलेस सीज मीन टू से द वॉटर, फॉर्मलेस सीज, द वॉटर ऑफ द सीज, इट वुड हैव नो फॉर्म. जुपिटर, समुद्र की झाग जिसको हम कहते हैं ना, द फॉर्म द फॉर्म दैट वी फाउंड ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द सी. सो ही सेइंग दैट ही सीज दे वुड बी एज क्लियर एंड क्लियर इन लाइक क्रिस्टल क्लियर, दैट देर वुड बी नो फॉर्म फाउंड ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ इट. हर बर्ड लाइटनिंग, सिट्रन ट्रीज, बट सिट्रन जो है इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ ट्री, ठीक है. सो सो इट्स बर्ड, दे वुड बी फील, दे वुड बी अट्रैक्टेड through this tree and in every purple veil, veil mean with a valley. So he's saying that that in every purple veil, in every romantic and attractive land, he would be the sole owner, he would be the lonely ruler of that particular romantic land. But this is a romantic land. Romantic means it gives you a feeling of satisfaction and you can say romance. Romance like you feel pleasure. You feel very soothing effect in the presence of all these things. So the Volubilis maid, he makes an attempt to have a flee from the world of reality into the world of imagination. And what kind, what a beautiful imagination that he has built up. So this is the poem we have done today, and I hope all of you have very much understood this poem, the explanation that I did, and I hope you will prepare this poem very well, and my prayers are with you beta, and I hope you will also remember in your prayers. So till tomorrow, stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.